who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters!
If there's something weird and it don't look good, who you gonna call? If you're seeing things running through your head, who can you call?
Ghostbusters!
An invisible man sleeping in your bed. Oh, who you gonna call?
TV jokes in York City. I'm LB Johnson.
And this is your boy, Uncle Wood.
And this is Shut Up and Talk TV.
How you doing there, boy?
I'm chilling, baby. I feel good.
I see you swinging and dangling.
Look,
there,
man,
sir.
I'm feeling real juicy, if you know what
hey,
I mean.
Hey, boy, I ain't seen nothing that glossy since patent leather.
Look, and I see you. Yeah, you're feeling real Afro-sheenish, if
Put
you will.
Put some hot sauce on my burrito, baby.
I see you, baby. I see you.
Feliz Navi, your daddy. So,
now, welcome everybody to another great Shut Up and Talk TV. As you know, Halloween is what, tomorrow?
It's tomorrow, baby.
So in honor of Halloween, tomorrow. You know, we got to bring out a little of our own glory, if you will.
You shine.
It's wet, baby. It's wet. Watch out now. Watch out, baby. Now, this is very special for me, you know, coming from one of, you know, with my hairline, I'm challenged in that department on any other day. But today, baby, I'm rocking, baby. I'm wet, baby. I'm wet with it. Watch me work. Watch
just
me work,
let
baby.
Your fire glow.
I did the slow motion.
I'm mad I hit that, though.
Yeah, you hit that, though. Look, that's that soprano, man. Look.
Hey, I'm just trying to get my pinata punctured. That's all.
It is a pleasure to see Uncle Wood, man.
Hey,
I ain't seen
Wood
him in a while.
Effect, that boy. You know how it is, that boy.
For those that don't know, introduce everybody. Who is Uncle Wood?
This is your boy, Uncle Wood. I'm your daddy's uncle, your mama's daddy, and your daddy uncle.
You heard it there first. Notice he's everything but not your daddy.
Not your uncle. I'm everybody else's uncle.
He ain't claiming that part of it. Like, I don't know you.
Oh, man, bro. Halloween, bro.
Yes. Okay, now. So much, bro, literally in the last week leading up to Halloween, there's been so many discussions on social media.
Which one are we going to go with? Because
I want to try to dive into a few of them. But the first one, of course, is you have the I call them super Christians, and they come with they bashing anyone that's celebrating Halloween.
Okay.
That's the first
now,
one.
That's been going on since the beginning
yeah,
of time.
Yeah.
And, you know, I knew people that didn't celebrate Halloween for that reason. Or they would go to church on Halloween.
Well, see, that's how I was raised. I was raised, you know, in a Christian home. And my mom, for many, many years, would not let us, we couldn't go trick-or-treat. We went to the harvest festivals at church. Mm-hmm. That's like the church's answer to Halloween. But you couldn't go trick-or-treat.
You got that shape, boy. You got that bounce back. Look at
watch
how
out, baby. So, so even with me, now, you know, having my own kids, and I believe my mom did an amazing job raising us. I respect and I love everything she did. But I think, you know, with everything, as you get older, you also come into, like, some knowledge. Mm-hmm. And you get educated. For me, it's weird, though, because folks think the idea is you're not supposed to celebrate Halloween, period.
Because it's supposed to be evil.
Yeah, it's evil. And if you celebrate Halloween, you're a devil worshiper and all this good stuff. See, and so folks think the church, to me, and I might be wrong, but this is my thoughts on it.
Okay.
The church, people think the church throws their events because it's like, oh, no, because if you celebrate Halloween, that's evil. But if you celebrate Harvest, you can do the Harvest Festival because that's okay. Right. Here's the reality. I think most churches, they celebrate it. They do a Harvest Festival because it's safer. The biggest thing about Halloween.
Oh, I see, because you won't be out in the neighborhood.
Exactly.
And the crazy people and
well,
stuff.
Well, and back in the day, we take you to the 80s and even early 90s, you know, there was a big,
oh, yeah.
It was a huge, every Halloween, a lot of kids came up missing.
Missing, and then they had like the needles and
candy. They used to put needle razors in the apples
and
stuff like that. So for those reasons, I think that's where the church adopted Let's have a harvest festival where the kids can come, still get candy, but it's safe. They don't got to worry about all the negatives that come with Halloween out in the public. And honestly, come on, we tell our kids don't talk to strangers, but then we say once a year, it's going to go knock on strangers' doors and eat all their candy and whatever they give you.
Well, hey, man, I'm all for the giving, bro.
Yeah, hallelujah.
I'm all for the giving. Yeah. Hey, I didn't say nothing when the stranger gave us food stamps, so I ain't tripping.
Hey, hallelujah. And that government cheese, look.
No, okay, look. One more thing I want to talk about.
Yeah.
The women's costumes. You
oh,
see that?
Okay, okay.
So I've seen a lot of dudes, I've seen a lot of people talking about this is just a time for the women to get naked.
No, dude, one, I actually seen one post, a dude, not post, but a comment, dude literally said, oh, it's finally the girls get to be a hoe for a day.
Yeah.
And I said, my God.
What's the problem?
First of all, don't be a hater. Second of all, like, here's my thing. Naturally, I enjoy and love visualizing the female body. So if the women feel like today is a good day to get sexy, you know, show some skin, I don't have an issue with it.
Right.
That's my personal opinion.
We can't say we want women to be confident and then in the next breath be mad that they come.
Come on now. You got to let it roll.
Hey, let it out. Look, fishnets, black pantyhose, all that.
But the other side of that, to that coin is, some women is too confident. Now, check it out. Now,
no such thing. I got eyelids. I can close them.
Now, if you put on that sexy outfit and literally you looking like one of them biscuits busting up out of that thing, ladies, it's time to let it go.
Look here, man. I ain't never turned down a plate of biscuits.
Look. Stop it up with some gravy.
Look,
but when it's all said and done, man, I really believe, and this is what I decided this year with my kids, I want them to enjoy the holiday.
Bro, look at us.
Come on, grown men. Come on, man.
Sitting here, Unc Wood.
Come on.
Let the show
you
go.
You see, man? Come on.
Shiny LB.
Hey.
It's all about having fun.
That's
I don't
it,
like
man.
All the political
yes,
mess.
Yes.
Making stuff, this not fun. This is a time where you, your kids,
come
your
on.
Family, your friends, you get together, you have fun.
And the biggest thing, and really parents, not just one thing for the kids to get dressed up, but parents, get dressed up, man.
Yeah.
Put on a cut, man. You know how my sons were running through the house cracking up when they seen this wig, man. They love it. And I'm in this bad boy. And the biggest part, I posted, bro. Honest to God, when I bought this and I put it on, bro, I didn't want to take it off.
Yeah.
I really understand why women feel some type of way when people talk about their lace fronts and their wigs. Because, bro, I'm in this thing. You can't tell me nothing, baby.
Hey, baby.
I'm good. And this ain't just no costume, baby. I rock this Friday night to the club.
Hey,
you see it.
I'm ready to go stuff a sopapilla right now.
Hey, bitty bitty bumba. Hey, man, at the end of the day, make sure you guys are safe tomorrow night, man.
Yes.
Make sure you go to neighborhoods and to people that you do know, whether you're doing your church thing or whether you decide to actually go and knock on random people's houses, doors, whatever, to get your candy. Just be safe in it, man.
Also, if you have kids in your neighborhood, get some candy,
man. Yeah, real talk,
don't be the only person on the block with your lights
Come
off.
On,
you don't
man,
want
look.
To have kids to get candy from you. Come on, man. Let the kids get the good
Me
candy.
Me and Bug used to turn our lights off. Now we open them doors,
man.
We hook them up with candy.
Yeah.
On that note, man, I got a sweet tooth. And we're going to take a break while I fix it. Let's go.
He comes to me at night.
Hey.
I call him to bed. He's burnt up like a weenie. And his name is Fred. He wears the same hat and sweater every single day. Last night, so the gang and I brought him to the lake. And even if it's hot outside, he wears it anyway. He's home when I'm awake, but he shows up when I'm asleep. I can't believe
Rez Collision Center is a proud sponsor of ProView Networks and Albuquerque Boxing. Rez Collision Center offers expert knowledge on any of your auto body and paint needs. Give them a call today, 505-254-4655, or stop by for a visit at 2415 2nd Street Northwest in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Rez Collision Center.
Car Crafters, proud supporter of ProView Sports Network.
Are you sure we're supposed to be doing this?
Don't worry, I've watched him do it 1,000 times. Come on, what's the worst that can happen?
No! Bad dog!
Hi, welcome to Car Crafters. What happened?
Don't worry, we'll make it like it never happened.
Car Crafters, it's like it never happened.
Well, I'm going to the frontier, walk to the cashier, order up a root beer and a number one. Cover it with green stuff, one scoop is not enough, find a booth is real tough. Back
by the Duke. Meet my family, meet my friends in the quirkiest restaurant I have ever been. All of Albuquerque's favorite spot. It's the Frontier Restaurant.
The Frontier Restaurant is a proud supporter of ProView Sports Network.
Don't sacrifice quality and flavor when you're in a hurry. Golden Pride offers ribs, fried chicken, green and red chili breakfast burritos, and Frontier Cinnabons. Four great locations, or visit us online at goldenpride@abq.com. Golden Pride Barbecue Chicken and Ribs, proud supporter of ProView Sports Network.
A whole new day. I thought I wasn't scared of him anyway until I noticed those rips in my sheets, and that was proof that there had been.
Yeah, on my street, man. Check it out. That particular song, man. First of all, shout out to DJ Ill Style doing his thing on the ones and twos.
Yes, sir.
That song, I got to tell you, man. I was probably 6 or 7 years old when that song came out. That's Fresh Prince, by the way, if y'all didn't know.
Yeah.
I remember,
that's when Nightmare on Elm Street was scary.
Yeah,
it wasn't funny.
Freddy, yeah, that's when it was.
It wasn't comedy. It was some
you
scary
literally
stuff.
Was scared to go to sleep and stuff. Mm-hmm. But my brothers, Callie and Dog, they had a. They used to do a paper route. And my other brother, Carlos, my dad's son, they would do a paper route at like 5, 6 in the morning.
Yeah.
Every morning. So we listened to that song for the first time. And then I just wanted to tag along because I'm a little brother.
Mm-hmm.
We had to go deliver newspapers, bro. And it was morning, but it's still dark out.
Yeah. You was scared,
and
bro.
And we had to go through this. It was a baseball field that you had to go through. And they used to lie and say it was hunted.
Yeah.
So, bro, literally, all I could hear is that song in my head. As we tried to deliver some papers, I was so scared, man. 6, 7 years old. So when I hear it now, yeah, I could jam to it.
Yeah.
But it also triggered me a little bit.
Yeah.
A little PTSD, but don't judge me.
Yeah.
But we are back. This is Shut Up and Talk TV, man. This is the Halloween edition.
Yeah, sir.
Speaking of Halloween, before we get on that, we got to dive into Buck. This weekend was crazy for the both of us.
Oh, yeah. So, LB, you know I went to Denver.
Yeah, man.
Did a little hosting thing for the little
concert. I hope you brought me back some favors, but we'll talk about that later.
Oh, man, them favors got done up,
See,
bro.
Look, it's a wrap.
Them favors got favored out. So, you know, I went to Denver. We did the, what was it called?
Well,
it turned into, they changed the name. It was called LA versus the Bay
Area. I didn't like that.
I didn't like that either.
Yeah.
But it was all of our favorite artists from back in the day. Yeah. You know, it was DJ Quick. It was E-40.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It was the Loonies. It was the Dog Pound.
The Squad.
And look, see, check it out, bro. Look at it. You see it, man. Everybody was there. Damn. Unfortunately, Warren G wasn't able to make it because his sister is actually in stage 4 cancer.
Damn.
So he couldn't come. He let us know that he wasn't able to make it.
Damn.
Everybody else made it. But I got a story for you, LB.
Okay, okay.
So it was funny that you're talking about the favors in Denver, Colorado.
Yes, 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 yes.
Because I want to say the majority of the crowd had a cloud over it.
Pretty, I think literally, I want to say 99.1%
right.
of people that live in Denver
right.
get lifted up.
And so I was thinking, I thought that helped your eyesight.
Yeah.
I thought it cleared up your glaucoma.
Like glaucoma, yeah.
Check this out, though. So after the show, there were some people who swore up and down I was Spice One.
I could see it.
So check this out. I want to show you what was taking place. Shout out to Six, man.
Yeah.
So I'm standing there, they yelling, Spice One, come take a picture with us, please. And so, you know, I was hitting the ad libs, blah. I was doing all that stuff, you know. And as you can see, look at the people. I'm taking pictures. Dude got his arm around me.
Bruh.
Dude in the back, yay, yay. I was like, Ice Cube wasn't even there, but he was talking about yay, yay.
You should have just started randomly like, but God said you. He's a liar. Kill them all.
Check the next one, though. Look at my face. They have no clue. I'm not Spice One, bro.
Hey, dude, behind you so gone, bro. I'm mad because it looked like that's probably his wife next to him.
Yeah.
But he hugging you like, hey.
Bro, they was like, OG, you're a legend. OG, take a picture with me. I'm like, the next morning when this wear off, they going to be mad as hell.
Did you tell anybody you weren't Spice?
No.
Focused.
Bro, we went to the after party. I got all type of favors. Hey, I want to tell you this. Spice One has some great groupies, I'll tell you that.
Hey, I've heard.
Has some great, look at the face, they have no clue. When they zoom in on that picture, when they get it on the Instagram, and they're gonna be like, that ain't no damn Spice
they
One.
They're gonna do the side by side.
That's Lowry's too, that ain't Spice One.
As you
bro,
should,
we
bro.
Had a ball though, you
very
know, man.
Focused.
We gotta get we, me and you. We haven't been
bruh,
to
it's
Denver
been a while.
With each other in some years, like
yeah,
4 or 5
yeah.
years. We gotta go back.
And it's funny. This was probably one of the first weekends in a long time that we had a lot of events.
Yeah.
And both and they were set. You were in Denver. I'm
yeah.
out here.
Yeah.
We had a lot going on. We had the Halloween what the hell they were called? Fantasy ball.
I'm gonna say it's
I said, what the hell did we call it?
It's your show, Ike.
Look, I know I wrote it. Look. But we had the Halloween fantasy ball at the yeah. Albuquerque Convention Center, man. It went down, man. I wanna shout out everybody came out. Lots of fun, bruh. Good times.
Yeah.
Some of these costumes, bro.
I already know.
Check it. So I'm at the door. I'm collecting tickets and things like that, and I'm trying mm-hmm. to be, a good host, if you
mm-hmm.
will.
Mm-hmm.
But you also want to be, trying to be respectful because it is a business. Mm-hmm. But bro, some of these ladies,
Was it fleshy?
It was flesh and bone.
Oh,
literally,
okay.
It was definitely
okay.
flesh and bone.
Yeah. Okay.
But when I say, bro, they came out.
Look at me. Look, they took it back to Spice One.
Look, represent, bro. Had to break. Breaking Bad, jumping off.
Oh, that's
but the ladies and the dudes, man, got very creative with these costumes, bro.
Yeah.
A lot of fun, man. We did the damn thing, bro.
I love Halloween.
Oh,
man.
Look, that's why,
Robin.
Look, when I hear the dudes come out and they talking trash about the girls getting sexy, I'm like,
yeah.
shut up.
Yeah.
Like I'm sorry, but shut up.
Let them do it.
Look,
man.
let them ladies live, man. Let them breathe. Honestly, and don't get it twisted. All the ladies weren't looking amazing, if you
right.
will. But they did their thing, man. And like you were saying earlier, ain't nothing better than just that confidence,
just having
bro.
Fun.
Yeah, man, having fun. You know, we had to represent, man. Shut
yeah.
up and talk. We in that bad boy. It was a good thing, man. Jazzy Hayes, T Streets came out and performed. Did they damn thing, bro.
Yes, sir.
The only thing,
oh,
man.
Oh, that's dope. That's
the,
dope.
The worst part, and I will say, bro, I made a mistake, man. I hired DJ Kid for free. Never again.
Oh
bruh.
No!
Never
bro.
Again,
what
bruh.
Was he playing,
oh,
man?
Oh, bro, it just it what he didn't have nothing, bro.
No music.
Man, I literally it got so bad.
Look,
oh, they
look,
stupid.
Did y'all, look, blah, blah. 40 water, 40 water. Same face. That's the same hey. Dude, bro.
Bro, it got so bad at one point, bro. I was
look.
Like, man, play Macarena, play something. But
wow.
other than that. Everybody had a good time, man. Good drinks flowing.
Yeah.
Good people. Good time,
yeah.
man. Another great event,
bro. I heard DJ Illstyle over there clearing his throat when you was
look,
talking
yeah,
about
yeah,
he
no.
hired a DJ.
See,
yeah, I hear you, man. You
see
how I do you, man?
Illstyle, you know, man, we green lit, man.
Yeah.
Trust me.
Yeah.
For going forward, bro.
Look at him. Look like you was, hey.
Brother
Rick James.
I was in rare form. It's funny. Okay, so all night long, I got Rick James.
Hey, you look like Rick Flames.
Bro, I got a couple.
Look at the face.
Little Richards.
Oh, yeah.
But then one dude came out and said, oh, are you Prince? And I literally, I stared at him just like that, bro, for a minute. Like, Prince, huh? That's what you got out of this. Was,
hey, I'm mad Jacala open. You got the
bruh,
taco meat
oh,
out.
Oh, bro, bro, look.
Bruh.
Hey, look,
oh,
hey,
what's
bro,
up?
Man, come bro. On, Jurassic Park was in that bad boy.
That's what's up,
had to get
man.
It live, man. Get it how you live,
no,
bro.
No, I love Halloween because it takes us all back. No matter
yeah.
how old you are, it'll take you back to being a kid, man.
The only way you lose or only way you don't have a good time at Halloween is honestly if you got issues with yourself,
there
man.
There you go, yep.
Like, to me, it's a perfect time to step out of your comfort zone,
yeah.
put on a wig, put on a costume,
yeah.
and just have a good time, bro.
There we go.
Clown around,
dark,
man.
It was dark.
Look,
here we go.
It was a couple of chicks that, They might have didn't look their best to me,
uh-huh.
but they whether they dudes or just their confidence, bro, they was doing their damn thing.
There we go.
And you, I was like, go on, get it, girl. Shake what your mama gave you. But when it was all said and done, man, it was a lot of fun.
Yes, sir.
Good time. Great week. Weekend.
Yeah.
We loved it. And after this break, we'll tell you more about it.
Yes, sir.
We'll be right back,
this
y'all.
This year, Halloween fell on a weekend. Me and Ghetto Boys were trick-or-treating. It was dark as death on the streets. My hands were all bloody from punching on the concrete. Yeah, Halloween fell on a weekend. Me and Ghetto Boys were trick-or-treating. Robbing little kids for bags. Till an old man got behind our rags. So we speeded up the pace. Took a look back, and he was right before our face. We were in for a squab, no doubt. So I swung and tried to take him out. I swung and...
frailty. What is desire? Diamonds. They say a life lived without passion is hardly worth living.
Ma'am? Ma'am? Ma'am?
Dang, this one made me feel all special.
Jackson Compaction wants to help you keep your green.
And keep the community green as well.
Jackson Compaction has worked hard to maintain the same prices since day one. Always easy and painless trash removal with professional crews and quality service. If it's non-hazardous waste, debris, or trash on your land, leave it to us. At Jackson Compaction, we're dedicated to ensuring the conservation of our environment.
You trash it,
we smash it.
Jackson Compaction, we've earned a reputation for great results.
Get into the game with Garden Swartz Team Sales. They have everything you need, from screen printing, embroidery, and digital printing services, high school letterman jackets, and all high school and club uniforms and individual and team apparel with the most reliable brands like Speedline, Rawlings, and Wilson. And don't forget to check out the latest F7 Shut helmet. It's all at Garden Swartz Team Sales. Give them a call, 505-884-1234. Garden Swartz Team Sales.
The more I swung, the more blood flew. Then he disappeared, and my boys disappeared too. Then I felt just like a fiend. It wasn't even close to Halloween. It was dark as death on the streets. My hands were all bloody
from punching on the concrete. Man, we are back. This is Shut Up and Talk TV, man. I do got to say R.I.P. Bushwick Bill,
yes,
man.
Yes, sir.
My mind's playing tricks with me. That was...
The Ghetto Boys.
Good, Ghetto Boys, man. You know, Bushwick Bill, man, was a big part of that. He passed away...
What, Black not, Chucky.
About 6 months ago, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
Not too long ago, he passed away, man. I did have the pleasure of actually meeting him, man. He did a show out here, mm-hmm. I think, last year.
Yep.
Got to meet him, man. Good dude. So R.I.P. to Bushwick Bill, but let's get back to this Halloween.
Yes, sir.
Now let me ask you, Buck. When it actually today? You know, that was this weekend was Halloween weekend, mm-hmm. but this Thursday is actual holiday. Mm-hmm. What are you planning for the actual holiday?
Oh, I gotta take my little mama out. My daughter. You know, me and her mom are gonna take her. She loves Mickey Mouse, Minnie Mouse, Clubhouse. So we got her the little Minnie Mouse. I got my ears. Her mom's gonna be Minnie Mouse too. Her bigger sister's gonna be Minnie. We're gonna take her, but we're going to the rich neighborhood.
Yeah, always.
We're going
man.
To Tanawan, baby. Hey, no. I'm going to stick out.
Look, like I tell everybody, don't waste your time in the hood,
nah,
man. Let's be honest. First of all, it's gonna be three houses with their lights off, one house with it on.
Right.
It ain't worth it.
They're gonna give you church candy, peppermint.
Man. Go up there.
Your look. Peppermint, lifesavers. No, you go to Tanawan, you get the whole watch.
Yeah,
Tanawan give you the real Snickers.
They be having them like king size and everything, bro.
Yeah.
Hit that. I think.
What you got going?
For me, man, I'll be in California. I'm mm-hmm. you know, I'll fly out tomorrow. Got to hit Cali. Going to see my oldest son.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna, you know, he usually takes his little brother out. So we'll probably do that a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm gonna connect with the little cousins, man. That you know, they grown too.
Yeah.
And see what we do, man. But I honestly, you know, for that, the grown up Halloween, man, I want to just do the scary movie marathon, man.
Oh yeah, that's a must.
Look, give me some good kettle corn. Give
that's
me some of that candy, man. You know, throw some little milk duds in there. Do, man, all the scary movies.
Let's do this then. All right, because we all about lists.
Yes.
Give me your top five best horror movie. Top five. No,
okay.
Matter of fact, we don't got to do five. We'll do three. You do three.
Best horror movies of all time to me, and I'm going to say based on movies that either did scare me or still scare me to date.
Yeah.
My first one, I'll say Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Not the oldest one, but the remake that had Jessica Biel in it.
Oh, okay.
That remake was not the one with they just came out with.
Yeah, I know.
But with Trey Songz, not that one.
Yeah.
But the one with Jessica Biel. That one
actually
had me scared in the theater.
Right.
That was a good one. I'll say that movie. I'm a huge fan of the Nightmare on Elm Street.
Yeah.
But like I said, they became more funny after that first one. So I would say Pet Sematary.
Okay.
The original.
The first one.
That was another one, bro, that when I seen mm-hmm. that, bro, that little boy, when he came back in.
Hey, that's what I don't
was,
like.
Was
I don't
walking
like
around.
Cats to this day.
Look,
I don't
bro,
like cats to this day.
When that little boy was scary as hell, bro.
Yeah.
So that, Pet Sematary, and then a shout out Stephen King, man. And I'll say my last one,
mm-hmm.
I got to say, because it was not like scary, like, but mm-hmm. it had some scary parts, but
what's
it
that?
Was hilarious to me in a good way. I got to say Child's Play, bro.
Man.
And here's what I'm saying, Child's Play. When Chucky said, When the little boy said, Chucky said Aunt such and such was a real bee and got what she deserved. Bro, I fell out my seat.
Yeah.
That was the hardest line, bro. Chucky was hardcore, bro. Man. The original. Not after they got all the mother brides in the
bro,
crap.
I'll beat Chucky's ass, bro. Ain't no little old nut. I'll tell you.
Nah, bro. Chucky,
I'll chuck him out, man. That's the one horror movie I feel like I would have survived.
Bro, I feel like, nah, see.
Ain't no little dude catching me, bro.
Chucky was a real life thug, bro. Like, yeah. I feel like if Chucky like really existed and all that was real. Yeah. Like the part two really would have been like Chucky in the hood.
Yeah.
Like running it though, like deep.
Yeah.
Cause in that bad boy, all of 311 walking through with that knife, like, hey cuz, where my money at though, cuz?
Nah, Chucky would have got his head blown.
Bruh, see, look.
Nah, okay, here's my top three.
Give it to me.
I'm gonna start with number three is the first Nightmare on Elm Street.
Okay, original Nancy.
You know why?
Yeah.
Because that actually had me scared to go to sleep.
You talking about the one with Johnny Depp and...
Okay. Where he grabbed the mama through the little hole in the door. Yeah.
They didn't want to go to sleep at all.
Number two. Man, this is a hard one, bro. Number two. I'm going to say Halloween.
Ooh, okay. See, I forgot about that.
The first Halloween.
Yeah.
Because the thing about Halloween... It's a scary movie, but the music, bro, when you hear that.
Yeah, bro,
you get to looking around.
Okay,
you
know, okay.
And it's like a tall white dude. That's scary,
I want to talk about Halloween, but finish your list. Then I want to go back to that movie.
Number one all time, and to this day, I won't watch it by myself. And you know me.
Give
Exorcist,
me.
Bro.
Oh, see.
I'm not messing with the Exorcist.
See, here, this is how you know.
I'm not, bro. No.
This is how you know. I was taunted.
Mm-hmm.
Not taunted, but the way I was brought up. I never was scared of Exorcist.
I was.
I hated Exorcist because it was evil. You know, I was raised in the church.
It was real.
But because I was raised in the church, I'm like, oh, devil? Nah, I ain't watch. Like, literally, you know, when you raised, you can't even watch movies with the devil in them.
Yeah, I had to see. My grandma was not.
If
my grandma caught us watching that in her house, we getting whooped. We getting beat down.
Here's how it messed me up. And this kind of will show you, like, my household when it comes to movies. Mm-hmm. Before I ever seen Exorcism, I don't know if you remember a movie with Leslie Nielsen, Repossessed.
Yeah.
And that was his.
That was like the satire.
If y'all don't know who Leslie Nielsen is, Google him, Becky Gunn, all
he
that.
He's the Weird Al Yankovic of Hollywood.
Literally.
Before
Wayne Brothers and some of the other ones was doing all the parody movies, Leslie Nielsen was the man when it came to parodies.
Yeah.
And he had Repossessed where he was clowning and you know.
Gunn.
Literally after seeing Repossessed and then seeing Exorcist, it was more like funny to me. It was like,
bro. I ain't with all that. The deep voice and the all of that. No, that because the problem was now when you go on YouTube, you can see like real exorcism.
Now you know it's legit.
They're speaking in different
like that
languages.
Like the exorcism of Emily Rose and all them.
I am good on that, bro.
What's weird is, bro, it's chicks in the South Valley that talk like that for real right now.
They ain't
possessed or nothing. They just, you know, too much green chili.
The first time TT's mama got mad at me, I found out that was real, bro.
real. Satan?
Bro, the neck went all the way around. You know how you, here's real stuff. I found out she was the exorcist, bro. When, you know when you get woke up and somebody got your phone?
Who is this?
Who is this you've been texting? Oh, man, how the heck do that? Bro, that was scary, bro. That's scary. Look, okay, number one, I forgot. My baby mama, then the exorcist.
Oh, okay. You know what, bro? You mentioned Halloween. And remember, I think it was part five. Remember the last one where you see the sister that stuttered and all that good stuff?
Yeah.
My problem with that movie, it was hella good.
Mm-hmm.
But they never, like, continued that. The next one was, like, H2O.
Yeah.
H20, whatever.
Yeah.
With Jamie Lee Curtis, which is older.
With Busta Rhymes.
But they never tell you what happened. Remember, somebody was following Michael Myers' hat into, like, the charger or whatever.
Yeah.
But you never find out who it is.
I'll tell you what. If you haven't seen the new one, it get back
the
to
new,
the essence.
The one with Jamie Lee.
Well, she's older.
Oh, I've seen it. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I want to. Well, look, man, look.
I'll tell
like
y'all a great scary movie. It's called Central on Saturday Night.
Look, man, them zombies be crazy.
The reviews on that one.
Look, it's not Central on Saturday Night. Our baby mama's any day.
There you
on
go.
On that note, hey man, happy Halloween. Happy y'all have a good
y'all
time.
Y'all be safe.
Don't eat razor apples.
Oh, he would play this. I'm leaving.
Let's go.